Transcribed.
Hey, Dean, is it time for us to go on yet?
Now, just a second, Jerry. Wait till I finish my Chesterfield.
Regular?
No, king size. Why?
Well, in that case, I'll have to wait over a fifth longer for you.
Which means the Chesterfield, first cigarette with premium quality in both regular and king size, brings you the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show.
Chesterfield is best for you, much milder, better tasting too. They're today's best cigarette buy.
Come on, smokers, why don't you try?
Chesterfield,
best for you.
Chesterfield, best for you. Regular, king size, either way. Make it Chesterfield today.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to bring you our master of ceremonies, Dean Martin.
Thank you. Hi there, everybody. Well, it's my favorite night of the week again, the night when we unwrap another regular and king-size show for Chesterfield, while my partner Jerry is working his way out of his mink-lined straitjacket. Wild horses couldn't keep me from singing Wild Horses. Hitch him up, Rich.
It would take more than a pack of wild horses pulling your wagon to keep you from me. It would take more than superior forces, even a dragon, to keep you from me. You can make fools out of other good guessers, put them in blinkers, I know where they'd be. It would take schools or the finest professors, using the thinkers, to keep you from me. What a sight you are, how bright you are, you glow. Take that sight away, and right away I'd go. Straight to your door over obstacle courses. Maybe I'm bragging, but surely you'd see. It would take more than a pack of wild horses pulling your wagon to keep you from me. Nothing can keep you from me. Take more than a pack of wild horses pulling your wagon to keep you from me. It would take more than superior forces, even a dragon, to keep you from me. Nothing can keep you from me. Nothing can keep you from me.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now, I have an announcement to make. We've had quite a few requests from people all over the country for pictures of Jerry and myself. And so I'd like to tell all you people who want pictures, there's only one thing to do.
Send us a camera and we'll take some.
It's Jerry Lewis! Now, Jerry, about those pictures. What are you laughing at, Jerry?
A riddle I made up this morning.
Why are you laughing now?
I just got it.
Oh. It must be a real comical one.
Oh, indeed, it is. Here's the riddle. Dean?
Yes?
What's the difference?
Jerry, didn't you leave something out?
Oh, yeah. What's the difference between?
Between what?
Oh, no, you don't, Dean Martin. I don't give any hints.
Well, you got to give me at least one hint.
All righty, Dean. What's the difference between a piano?
What's the difference between a piano? Now, that's idiotic.
No, but you're warm.
Jerry, you're crazy.
You guessed it.
Look, Jerry, I'll give you an example of a real riddle. Are you ready?
Gee, that's a tough one.
I didn't start yet, Jerry.
Oh, Dean. I wish you'd teach me how to be a funny storyteller. When I go to the parties, the only way I can entertain is to play the piano.
Well, it's always nice to have somebody at a party who can play the piano.
Yeah, but after a couple of hours of playing, my toes get tired.
Oh. Jerry, you play the piano with your toes? What do you do with your fingers?
Stick them in my ears. I can't stand my playing.
Dear, storytelling calls for a certain talent. In other words, storytellers are born.
Then it should be easy for me. I was born.
Naturally.
Of course. Who's born with clothes on?
Okay, you were born.
And I remember it so well, Dean. It was a long time ago on a Monday night. No, it was a Wednesday night. On second thought, it was a Thursday night.
Oh, who cares? Maybe you were born on a Tuesday night.
Now, that's ridiculous, isn't it, Dean? You know on Tuesday nights I'm always broadcasting.
That's right, that's right. I keep forgetting.
Of course, I could have been born transcribed, though.
Oh, Jerry.
To be released at a more convenient time.
Jerry. Now, Jerry, the best way to be a good storyteller is to talk about strange or funny things that happened to you.
You mean like the time I was drinking a malt at the game waiting somebody slapped me on the back?
That's a funny experience.
Sure was. It took three men to pull me out of the straw.
Jerry? It's okay to exaggerate a little. Oh, but don't overdo it.
Then maybe I can tell about the strange experience I had last year when I went to Europe on a Normandy.
Jerry, the Normandy sank 10 years ago.
Then I better make it another boat.
Yeah. Exactly, Jerry. When you tell the story of something that happens to you, you're supposed to tell the truth.
I'm coming to that part.
Okay, I'm waiting.
Well, I boarded the boat in New York, and it took me 5 days to get to Europe and 30 seconds to fly back.
5 days to get there and only 30 seconds to fly back. Now, that's impossible.
No, 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 not when you suspend as a court on a dock.
This is the truth?
I've got witnesses.
What witnesses?
My bare legs.
That's all well and good, Germ, but the legs can't talk.
Oh, they can so, too. I've seen Betty Grable's, and I get the message.
Years ahead of them all. Chesterfield is years ahead of them all. The quality contrast between Chesterfield and other leading brands is a revealing story. Recent chemical analyses give an index of good quality for the country's six leading cigarette brands. The index of good quality table, which is a ratio of high sugar to low nicotine, shows Chesterfield quality highest.
Chesterfield quality highest.
15% higher than its nearest competitor.
Chesterfield quality highest.
31% higher than the average of the five other leading brands.
Yes, Chesterfield is first with premium quality in both regular and king size.
Don't you want to try a cigarette with a record like this? Chesterfield.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure now to introduce a brand new song for its debut on the air. And by the way, I happen to be related to this new number because it was written by none other than that very talented piano player of ours, Mr. Lou Brown. It's called The Time Is Now.
Forget the past. The sands of time are falling fast. So hold me tight, my love. This is our night, my love. The world will whirl around. Your warm embrace makes time stand still. We lies ahead. The far horizon glows with red. The stars are gone, my love. Hold back the dawn, my love. The time is now. Far horizon glows with red. The stars are gone, my love. Hold back the dawn, my love. The time is now.
It becomes my extremely pleasant task to introduce our guest. Tonight we've invited...
Ding, ding, the fatal time has come. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die.
Oh, Jerry, stop. What makes you think you're gonna die?
I just broke my lifetime pen.
Oh. Oh, please, Jerry. Please. I'm trying to make an introduction here. I'm making an introduction, Jerry. Our guest is every man's dream come true. Her complexion looks like it was kissed by moondrops.
Oh, the cruel unfairness of it all. Never to see a girl again. Never to kiss a girl again.
Oh, Jerry.
And just when I was learning to use both lips.
Jerry, since you're convinced you're going to die and never see a girl again, your last look is going to be terrific. Ladies and gentlemen, here's a chance for you also to help us welcome the beautiful, charming, and exciting star, Miss Joanne Dru. Ladies and gentlemen, Joanne Dru.
Thank you, Dean.
Nice to see you, Joanne.
Say, what's with Jerry? He has such a strange expression on his strange face.
Miss Dru, this is no time for levity. My days are numbered.
Jerry, you're mistaken about all this.
No, I'm not. The symptoms are all too evident. Too evident. All day long, I've been seeing black spots and white spots in front of my eyes.
Oh, my goodness. Didn't you see a doctor?
No, just black spots and white spots.
Jerry, you're wrong.
No, I'm not. Just look at my skin. It's the color of the cement in front of Grauman's Chinese Theater.
Well, so what? Lots of people have skin the color of the cement in front of Grauman's.
With footprints in it?
Jerry, you know, I got an idea. Why don't you go out to your uncle's ranch in Montana?
Oh, that sounds like a great idea. I'll bet it's really invigorating out there. They say the air in Montana is so intoxicating. When you breathe it, it's like breathing wine.
Oh, no wonder my uncle joined Air Anonymous.
Jerry, on the ranch, you can get lots of fresh milk.
That's right, and milk builds bones.
Then how come cows are so flabby?
No, Jerry, milk is full of vitamins.
Vitamins?
Yes. A, B, C, D, E.
She can't even spell vitamins.
It will also help that sallow complexion of yours.
Now, look what milk has done for my skin. Every morning I take a milk bath.
Last time I was at the ranch, I took milk showers.
Oh, that's ridiculous. How could you take milk showers?
Tall cows.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Believe me, Jerry, the thing for you to do is spend a few weeks on your uncle's ranch.
Oh, I can't go back there. My uncle hates me. Oh. At breakfast, he used to take a knife and fork and try to cut up my pancakes for me.
Well, Jerry, if he tried to cut up your pancakes, that shows he likes you.
After I ate them?
No, no.
you're not welcome at the ranch, the best thing for you to do is take it easy. Stop running around nights. Stay home and watch television.
You'll find it very relaxing, Jerry.
Oh, I do enjoy television, especially on cold, wintry nights.
Oh, then you do watch it.
No, I warm my feet on the tubes.
What you ought to do, Jerry, is climb into your Snuggies and watch the Late, Late, Late Show.
That's not for me. I saw a movie on TV last night. Believe me, I was disgusted.
Disgusted?
Just when the commercial started to get interesting, some wise guy interrupted with a picture.
Well, of course, there are very few activities without commercials nowadays. You know, if this isn't controlled, I can imagine what'll happen.
You don't have to imagine, Joni. That's what our play is about tonight. Fenneman, come here and take over.
Right, Dean. Ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, almost everything today is sponsored. Thank heaven. And so tonight, we'd like to show you what might conceivably happen during an operation in a hospital if it, too, were commercially sponsored.
Well, we're all set for the operation. Is my assistant ready?
Yes, doctor.
Very well. Forceps.
Forceps.
Suture.
Suture.
Fine, now I'm ready to carve.
Doctor, aren't you forgetting something?
Oh, yes. Patient.
Yeah.
Where's the patient?
Here I am. Oh, doctor, I'm so frightened. This is my first operation.
Then we're all even. This is my first, too.
Oh, no.
Oh, he's just kidding, ma'am. Hey, if you want to find out how successful Dr. Lewis has been, contact his last patient.
Yes, just write to Sam Fromkes, Box 42.
Box 42?
Forest Lawn, California.
And now for the incision.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first 3 inches of this incision are brought to you by the makers of Gloppo Hair Tonic. The hair tonic that doesn't pour, it glops. Now a word from one of our satisfied movie stars, Mr. Cary Grant.
Gloppo Hair Tonic grows hair faster than anything I've ever tried. I bought a bottle of Gloppo Hair Tonic, pulled the cork out with my teeth, and the next morning I had a mustache on my tongue.
And now, back to our operation.
I'll be sawing you in all the old familiar places. Clamps, scalpel, blindfold.
Doctor, is the blindfold for me?
No, for me. I can't stand the sight of blood. And now I must hurry with the operation. I'm double parked.
We interrupt to bring you a message from another one of our co-sponsors, the manufacturers of Burr Food Freezers. And here's a word from the president of the Burr Food Freezer Company.
Evening, friends. My name is Harold J. Burr. Now, if you purchase one of our food freezers, we will stock it for you absolutely free with the following item: 300 pounds of choice lizard gizzard. 200 pounds of frog's legs taken from frogs who walk on their hands. And 12 dozen kangaroo patties individually wrapped in their own pouches. Also, 3 1/4 miles of giraffe neck. And as an added inducement to all you cannibal kitties in Africa, 2 dozen frozen explorers on a stick.
As a free gift from the Burr Food Freezer Company, the first 3 million ladies who call in will receive absolutely free a beautiful hand-stitched parachute harness.
If you live in the Hollywood area, the number to call is Granite 647-989-3621-943. I repeat, that number is Webster 620059. Now, don't forget, folks, if you'd like some information about our freezer, call Citrus 1357.
If you live in Egypt, the number to call is Sand Dune 164.
The number is Gesundheit 1367.
And in Switzerland, it's Alp 2 1 3 4.
And now, back to our operation.
Doctor, all the lights went out in the operating room.
Quick, Dr. Martin, get me a candle.
But, Doc, you can't operate with a candle.
Yes, I can. Get me one with a sharp wick.
Oh. Hey, Dr. Lewis, the patient is getting violent. It took three of us to take her temperature.
Three?
Yeah, two to hold her mouth open and one to pull the thermometer off the wall.
Let me see that thermometer. Complications have set in.
What am I suffering from?
A rare case of snow followed by rain.
Doc, you should have given her an injection of penicillin.
We're all out of penicillin. I gave her the next best thing.
What's that?
A shot of moldy bread.
Isn't that quick thinking?
Dr. Lewis, when I come out of this, can I have a private room?
No. Is that clear? We're very crowded in this hospital. I'll have to put you in with eight other women.
You mean eight in a room?
No, eight in a bed. Now I must continue with the operation.
Folks, we'll get back to our operation after a brief message from another one of our sponsors. The biggest used car dealers in Southern California, the Smiling Schmoes.
Evening, friends. I'm Sam Smiling.
And I'm Irving Schmo. We have 3,000 fine used cars for you on a lot 9 feet by 12.
9 feet by 12?
That's right. We pile them on top of each other.
Oh. We can sell our cars cheaper than anybody else for one simple reason. They're stolen.
Well, here we are. Here we have a real clean 1904 Super Deluxe Snark. This is an ideal transportation car. You can always take it to work if you live around the corner.
It has chrome wheels, chrome bumpers, chrome fenders. As a matter of fact, this is the chromiest car you've ever seen.
And this car is only $1,200 down. That's not dollars, that's feet. It fell into a coal mine.
And now, back for the conclusion of our operation.
Ready to continue, Doc?
Yes. Oh, give me something to dismember you by.
Doctor, please stop. Tell me, Doctor, after the operation, will the scar show?
Honey, that depends on you.
Don't worry, miss. The last patient the doctor had was a fan dancer.
Yeah, and she wanted the scar where it wouldn't show.
Well, what did you do, Doctor?
I operated on her sister.
Chesterfield is best for you. Listen to Chesterfield's record.
For a full year and 2 months, a doctor has been making regular examinations of a group of Chesterfield smokers. And he reports no adverse effects to the nose, throat, and sinuses from smoking Chesterfields.
Don't you want to try a cigarette with a record like this? Chesterfield. First with premium quality in both regular and king size. Chesterfield. First choice with young America. And that's from a survey of 274 colleges and universities. Try Chesterfields today. Remember, Chesterfield is America's best cigarette buy.
You know, friends, Jerry and I feel that we owe a sincere vote of thanks to all you wonderful people who have visited your neighborhood theaters to see our latest picture, The Stooge. Believe us, you're tops in our books. And now here's a song that's tops in our books.
Do not forsake me, oh, my darling. This our wedding day. Do not forsake me, oh my darling. Wait along. I do not know what fate awaits me. I only know I must be brave, and I must face a man who hates me. coward, a craven coward, or lie a coward in my grave. Oh, to be torn twixt love and duty, supposing I lose my fair hair beauty. Look at that big hand move along, nearer than I knew. He made a vow while in the state's prison, vowed it would be my life or his, and I'm not afraid of death, but oh, what will I do if you leave me? Do not forsake me, oh my darling. Made that promise as a bride. Do not forsake me, oh my darling. Oh, although you're grieving, don't think of leaving. Now that I need you by my side.
That beautifully, Dean.
Oh, thanks, Joni.
Jerry, how come you don't do any singing on this program?
Oh, I used to, but I can't anymore because of my condition. I have an upside-down stomach.
Well, that's terrible, Jerry. How did you ever get an upside-down stomach?
My singing turned it.
Jerry. Jerry. No slight intended, but I think it's time for me to be leaving now.
Sorry to see you go, but sure glad you could be here, Joanne.
Yes, Miss Dru, you certainly made our night brighter.
Thanks, it was great fun. Good night, Dean and Jerry.
Good night, Joanne.
Good night, Joanne.
Wow.
Friends, Dean and I really appreciate hearing from you smokers who have taken our advice and changed to milder Chesterfields.
It's good to know you agree with what we've been saying. Regular or king size, Chesterfield is best for you.
You folks who haven't tried them yet, pick up a carton. They really are mild and they taste great. You'll like Chesterfield.
So until next week, this is Dean Martin.
And this is Jerry Lewis saying
good night, everybody.
You've just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show, produced and directed by Dick Mack, written by Arthur Phillips and Austin Kalish, with music prepared and conducted by Dick Stabile. And this is George Fenneman reminding you to listen to Chesterfield's award-winning show, Dragnet, Sunday night on the same NBC station.
Now, new Fatima has the tip for your lips. Fatima tips of perfect cork. King size for natural filtering. Fatima quality for a much better flavor and aroma. So remember, new Fatima has the tip for your lips. Fatima, see how smooth they are.
Remember, Fatima is made by the makers of Chesterfield, Liggett and Myers, one of tobacco's most respected names.
Tonight, visit Fibber, McGee, and Molly on NBC.